foremost, I want to start out by introducing some of the agencies and people that are with us this afternoon. First, Chief Michael Beckner with Southeastern Police Department, right behind me. Ponchatoula Police Chief Bree Larrison, Louisiana State Police Captain Colada, Drug Enforcement Agency Assistant Supervisory Agent in Charge Paul Seal, Homeland Security Investigation Supervisor Brian Grayson, and Deputy Special Agent in Charge Adam Parks. We have Ms. Angel Monastir with the 21st Judicial District, District Attorney's Office. We also have ATF and Jefferson Parish Sheriff's Office that was a part of this organization or this operation that we had going. The main reason we wanted everyone here today was to discuss a new initiative that we have in the city of Hammond, as well as Tangipo Parish and the North Shore. We have a thing called the FORT team. It's the Fentanyl Overdose Response Team. Fentanyl is a challenging issue that we are having throughout our communities, everywhere. Nobody is isolated from it, and we are finding more and more issues with overdoses and people getting injured and hurt and possibly even dying due to this drug. Part of this fentanyl overdose response team is when we have people that overdose, whether it be fatal or non-fatal, we respond. We come out immediately. We get information, we begin investigating, and our officers then go after the people that are not only selling the drugs, but the people that are distributing it, passing it on to people, whether it be a friend or anyone else. The goal is to get better prosecution, and that's part of the partnership we have with the District Attorney's Office, and we've worked with them. And the goal is to get to better prosecution so we can charge these people that are distributing these narcotics with charges such as attempted murder or murder in the process. At this time, I'd like to call up DEA Special Agent Paul Seal. He's going to explain the fentanyl overdose response team a little bit more to y'all.
Good afternoon. It's a great day when you come here and you see everybody behind me working together as one, and that's exactly what we've been doing. Again, my name is Paul Seal. I'm the Assistant Special Agent in Charge of the Drug Enforcement Administration. We're based out of New Orleans, Louisiana. We cover four states: Alabama, Louisiana, Arkansas, and Mississippi. So we have a large area. I work mainly down here. I have a couple groups that are actually assigned to Chief Bergeron here. So today I just want to talk about our new FORT team, what it's about and what we do. Like I said, it's an honor to be here today, a part of this newly formed partnership with our local and state agencies to combat the fentanyl poisonings. And it's different now. You know, before we always called it an overdose. Well, DEA changed its wording. It's a poisoning. And why do we call it a poisoning? DEA refers to fentanyl overdoses as poisonings due to the fact that many people who take the fentanyl don't realize they're taking it. They have no idea. And that's the scary thing about it. So less than about a year ago, I would say 6 months ago, me and Chief met Chief Bergeron, and I want to thank him, first of all, for his support, his leadership. It's a big part of getting this group together at first on the ground. He invited us to his police department, and I brought my whole team there, so we appreciate that and his support. But the Chief and DEA, we've teamed up together to form an ongoing partnership to combat the fentanyl overdoses in the surrounding area. We've received total support, and Chief mentioned it, from the District Attorney's Office here, and then also the District Attorney's Office in St. Tammany Parish. Scott Perilou, Colin Sims has cooperated and assisted us greatly in this effort, had met with us several times, so we definitely appreciate their support. Jefferson Parish, Louisiana State Police, all fully on board on this mission. Well, you can see this week where we've had successes. Ponchatoula Police Department, Southeastern Police Department, they've been on board for a while, and we look forward to working with them and having more successes. Our main goal is to use a force multiplier in resources from DEA to assist in all local and state agencies to identify distributors in this community. When we find the distributors, we want to work together with the District Attorney's Office and also the U.S. Attorney's Office to obtain the strongest prosecution to include homicide. And I want to go over a few stats that are out there right now that DEA has here recently. Every day, 300 people die of fentanyl poisoning. We call it poisoning now. 7 out of 10 pills that DEA seizes, so if we went on the streets here in this parish and we seized 10 pills, 7 out of those 10 would have a deadly dose of fentanyl. 70% chance that you could overdose. Just think about that. That's a scary thought. 18 to 45, number one cause of death for the CDC is drug poisonings. You know, all this fentanyl is in Mexico. The two cartels that the DEA is concentrating on is the Sinaloa cartel, which is one of the biggest, CJNG, and they're producing all the fentanyl in Mexico, and they're getting the precursors from China. So DEA in the big picture right now, we're looking to combat those cartels. But there's a whole other side of this picture, and this is where the Fort group comes in. You have victims. We have family members. We have sons, daughters, friends that are overdosing. So what our team is trying to do is come together as one unit to try to obtain the homicide charges, to try to find the individuals in our community that's distributing this fentanyl. And working together as one like this, it makes it a lot easier. We would combine intelligence, work together every single day to do this. And this win this week and what we were able to do saved lives. Anytime we arrest one person, seize a bag of fentanyl, we save a life. And that's the way we think about it. So today, I want to thank everybody here, our federal partners, HSI, ATF. We're always working together. But our state partners and our local partners that have come in and just bought in totally to allow us to come in, help them. DEA cannot do this by ourselves. It's impossible. We have to have police departments like Hammond PD and Ponchatoula, and these police departments that we work together every single day, we have to have them to be successful. And I see a lot more wins like this, more arrests, more seizures coming. So I want to tell everybody here, we appreciate it and the support and everything that we do. Thank you.
At this time, I'm going to speak briefly in reference to the case which he has referred to. Shortly after creating the Fort team within Hammond or Tangipahoa Parish, we were contacted by Southeastern Louisiana University Police Department. Their quick response, their great work, was what able to get this original case and our first case under our belt and the prosecution. But before we get into the details of the case, Southeastern Police Chief Michael Beckner would like to speak a little bit.
Afternoon. Again, I'm Southeastern Police Chief Michael Beckner. What I want to say, you know, one, as you can say, the collaboration between all the agencies has led to some arrest in this case. First and foremost, we're a community of 10,000 18 to 25 year olds. And as you heard, it was 18 to 45 year olds is the leading cause of death. Well, so we have 18 to 25 year olds that go out and they make mistakes. We did have a student who was poisoned by fentanyl. Our officer's quick reaction was able to administer Narcan and get her some medical treatment, and she's out walking around today because of our officers that did that. Based on the information that we got and the formation of this new team, we immediately contacted them to pool our resources together and start working this case. You know, Southeastern is a learning environment. We want our students to be safe. This was an isolated incident on Southeastern. To be completely transparent, you can look at our Cleary stats on our web, and we list all drug offenses and alcohol offenses and major crimes that happened on campus the last 3 years, and that's readily available to anybody. We were able to work together, get this taken care of, and that way it keeps our community and our campus safe for our students. I'll turn it back over to Chief Bergeron, and he can give you details of the case.
So sometime around mid-January, we were contacted by Southeastern Police Department in reference to a poisoning that happened on their campus. This was a non-fatal poisoning. They worked with our fentanyl overdose response team. Our team was able to respond. They were able to get information and begin the investigation. It was determined that these narcotics were brought. It was first off, the victim was a local person to the Hammond or Tangipahoa Parish area. The fentanyl was brought to this person from yet another local person who was not a student. Through the course of the investigation, they were able to identify not only the person who brought the narcotics to the student, but also the person that person purchased the narcotics from. It's so important that we link these people together. As of recent, 2 days ago, we conducted a search warrant on the residence, and We'll be willing to provide a picture of some of the items that were taken and we recovered. I will tell y'all that it was almost a pound of crystal meth. We had large quantities, or at least some quantities of heroin, cocaine, marijuana, and at least three guns, one being a rifle. These are people that are putting these drugs into our community, that are affecting our community, affecting our loved ones. Anybody who thinks that their family can't be affected, count your blessings, because you haven't been affected yet. There's no family, no matter it be economic status or political status or any status, that can feel like they're, you know, completely a bubble around them and can't be affected with the narcotics and the issues that we have in our communities. This is not an isolated issue to Hammond. This is a nationwide issue. We have a nationwide issue. We have a regional issue. We have a serious issue with narcotics and fentanyl. In today's day and age, fentanyl, small amounts and doses, can have somebody overdose, and somebody could lose their life. So that being said, several arrests have been made. The arrests that have been made so far, it was a Shaheem Pines, was booked for the following charges: two counts of distribution of Schedule 1, three counts of distribution of Schedule, actually five counts of distribution of Schedule 1, five counts of possession with intent to distribute Schedule 2, three counts of possession of firearms in the presence of the narcotics, as well as attempted murder charges. We've charged people for a long time with the narcotics. The new thing that we're stepping up is we're going to charge these criminals that are selling the dope, that are having people get poisoned, come close to losing their lives or lose their lives, with the attempted murder charges. The district attorney's office has been gracious to get on with us. We're working hard. This is not something that's regular, guys. It's not something that happens all the time. This is actually fairly new with us charging people with those attempted murders. But I can tell you that we're willing to be the pioneers to go after these drug dealers in this way. The other person, two other people that were arrested, it's Kawish, sorry on the pronunciation, Brown, also booked with multiple drug offenses, possession of firearms, as well as going to be the attempted murder. And then there was a third person that was arrested. Sorry, I'm looking for the name now. Mr. Mark Fridge III was also arrested. And this is the person who actually delivered the narcotics to the person that was poisoned. Listen, it doesn't matter if it's a person that goes to Southeastern or a person in our community. It's a person that's affected. It's a family that's affected. It's something that we have to be vigilant. And the only way we can accomplish this is by working together. This isn't a testament to what we can accomplish when we all work together. Everybody came together. They got the job done. Once again, I can't praise Southeastern Police Department and the university for such a quick response. They sit in the middle of our city. They sit in the middle of the city of Hammond. They don't have a bubble around them. People from our community that are selling drugs are going to end up going on their campus. But the fact that they were able to respond, were able to take the actions that they took, the professional way that they handled things, is what allowed us to get to the situation that we're in, that we are now putting these people in jail for attempted murder, for distributing narcotics on our streets that almost killed someone. Anybody else have anything you want to add? Is there any questions?
Chief, did several drug busts really over the past few weeks, as you know, and Huntsville, you guys just had one. Are these recent drug busts all a result of this team?
No, listen, I think that this is just an additive. The Fort team is an additive team. It's a team that's coming out just like a detective would come out if there was a major crime. This team's responding. They get called out in the middle of a night if there's an overdose, if there's a poisoning that they need to respond to. So, I think that these guys absolutely play a part in that. But that being said, you know, those things probably would have still occurred. This is just a new way and a new approach for us to reach to it. And as Special Agent Seal mentioned, you know, when we went and had that meeting, my goal was to bring the federal partners into an area here in Hammond and to help us in the Hammond area. We've had every city police chief within our parish. I know they've met in other parishes. I hadn't been involved in those, but every police chief within the city or within Tangipahoa Parish is on board with this fentanyl overdose response team. So I think it's an addition to what we currently have. This is the first major case that we have had as a team and going after the people for the attempted murder.
So the incident on the university's campus, that's what team now?
No, this team was actually formed prior to that. We started getting the team together. We talked about it. We talked about the challenges that our community was facing. And one of the challenges we're facing, look, Hammond Police Department responds to a lot of poisonings, a lot of overdoses on a weekly basis. It's unfortunate. This fentanyl is no joke, and the people that think it is, they just don't understand. They haven't been affected by it yet. But no, this team was being created already. Because we were able to create this team and we were able to get the collaboration with everybody and all the other chiefs on board with Southeastern Police Chief Beckner, for him to jump on board and say, look, I think this is a great idea, and then the case happened afterwards. So it was the fact that we had this team in place, we had the foresight to come up with something like this or to adopt something like this that the DEA does into our region, in our area, and then this case just happened to come through.
Have you had a lot of fentanyl poisonings in this area of the
state? I can tell you our officers respond to overdoses, I would say probably daily. You know, it's 100%, it's an epidemic. We are dealing with an epidemic in our community, in every other community. Now, just because we say overdose, let's be clear, that doesn't mean it's fatal. These could be non-fatal overdoses. They could be Narcan and brought back, and that happens on a regular basis. But, I think that every community is feeling the realm of fentanyl and the overdoses, and I just think it's how you react to it. And that's why it's our job and our goal to react as quick, as swiftly, and to get on board and to go after these people with the cooperation of the district attorney's office to really prosecute these people and make sure that they can't continue to do these things. If you don't mind, I can provide them to you after the fact. You know, the message I want to send is this. First off, Hammond is a great community. Southeastern is a great university. We're a safe community, and we have a safe university. That doesn't mean we live in a bubble. You know, the message I want to send to parents is, number one, you can feel safe sending your kids here and trust that you raised them the way that you should have raised them, and they're going to listen to you when they do that, when they come to this university. But don't assume that whether it be any type of drug, is okay to use. In today's day, when they lace the drugs with fentanyl, such a small dosage of fentanyl can kill you. It's just not worth it. Come to school, get your education, enjoy yourself, have a good time. Enjoy the fruits of our city and our community, but be careful on what you do. Don't make the decisions that you wouldn't make in front of your parents. It is. So the one thing with the police department is we have several officers that are task force officers. We have what they call TFOs. We have TFOs on Homeland Security Investigations, HSI's team, ATF, as well as DEA. So yes, it is a specific team that is put together. It's officers that get extra training. They get the little bit furtherance. They work with the district attorney's office closely, and that way they can go out, and it's just like a detective who would respond to a major robbery scene. They have the extra training, the extra expertise to go out and be able to work this case to where we can do the best we can to put ourselves in a situation to not only get prosecution but conviction.
Chief, how many members are on this team combined?
So I will tell you, as of right now, every city police department in Tangipahoa Parish has agreed to participate in the fentanyl overdose response team. I would tell you that there is 8 to 9 on a regular basis officers that are assigned and currently working anything that comes out and responding to anything that they believe would be a case that they would be prosecuting or trying to get prosecution on. Is there any other questions? All three subjects that I mentioned their names were arrested in reference to that overdose. All three of them were arrested. The fridge individual was the one who actually delivered the narcotics to the person.
And they were arrested in connection to the search warrant?
They were arrested in connection to the whole investigation. Yeah, this is all one investigation altogether, and we were able to make the arrest based on the totality of the investigation.
Chief, what were they arrested when they were all
They were not all arrested together. The arrests were made on Tuesday. All right, guys. Well, look, we appreciate y'all coming out. We're excited about this. We plan on giving y'all as much information as possible because this is going to be an ongoing thing. We believe that we're going to be an agency in a region that people are going to follow behind in getting this type of stuff together and making sure that we get the proper prosecution. Once again, I want to thank all my local, federal, and state partners for their participation in this. We as a community of law enforcement individuals have to work together. We only solve this problem by being one team and working together, and I really want to thank you guys for being part of this team. Thank y'all.